Good morning, viewers. You're welcome to the program, Let There Be Light. And today, somebody's light will come today in Jesus' name. You know, the Lord has sent me here to come and bring light. Even as you're going to sleep, or some of you, you wait to watch the program. Before you go to sleep, your light will come. You will not be tormented again after this program in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord that sent me here will back you up in the name of Jesus Christ. And I hand the studio, everything, the viewers, over to God. Father God, Lord, I say over to you in the name of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over this program. And Lord God Almighty, you take charge in the name of Jesus Christ. I disappear. You appear to your people in the name of Jesus Christ. They will see you in the name of Jesus Christ. They will hear you in the name of Jesus Christ. And your glory will be yours forever in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. So you're welcome to the program in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let there be light, and your light has come. Last week we started the topic, let there be light. And the topic is from God. It's the first words recorded in the Bible, Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, that God spoke. He says, let there be light. And God said, let there be light. So if he didn't say, nothing would have happened. Bible said the earth was null and void, without form. Darkness was upon the face of the deep. But in that darkness, God was in that darkness. I will go deeper in the mighty name of Jesus Christ today, in the name of Jesus Christ. So we are moving now to Psalm. We'll go to Psalm 119, verse 105. I'm going to show you that in every light has a source. It has a channel in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Psalm 119, verse 105, it says, the word is a lamp unto my feet. This word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So the channel of light is the word of God. Without the word of God, there is darkness. Without the word of God, there is nothing. And that word, the word of God was birthed by God, by the breath of the living God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And then we'll move to in verse 130 of the same Psalm 119. Verse 130 says, the entrance of your word gives light. When the word of God comes in, light comes in the name of Jesus Christ. When the word of God comes in, it dispels darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The entrance of your word gives light. It gives understanding unto the simple in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now you have to humble yourself to understand the word of God. It is the word that is revealed by the Spirit of God. Without the Spirit of God, we cannot do anything. Without the Spirit of God, we cannot learn anything. Without the Spirit of God, nothing will be revealed. Without the Spirit of God, no healing will come forth. Without the Spirit of God, no life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The same Spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead, that's the Spirit I'm talking about. The same Spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead, the same Spirit that put me here now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that Spirit will visit you in the name of Jesus Christ. He will not only visit, he will dwell with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every darkness will dispel as we go through these scriptures in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Then we'll move to Psalm 107. Verse 20. Psalm 107, verse 20. Let's go. Go with me to Psalm 107, verse 20. And God will take the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will be glorified. He says he sent his word. This one is a deep scripture. He says he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. He sent his word. He, God, sent his word. Now, it has two phases here. He sent his word, which is this Holy Bible that I'm speaking from, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That is the word of God. That is what we know and we believe that is the word of God. Documented word of God. Now, that is his word. But he also sent his word, the Jesus Christ. He also sent his word through man. Man was also spoken word of God, let there be light. And Jesus said, you are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. The light that was spoken when the world was in darkness. You are that light. He said, I am the light. As he is, so are we in this world. First John 4:17. As he is, so are we in this world. That is he saying. He says, he sent his word and he healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Now he sent this word. He didn't just send this word. He's sending it through a vessel. And that vessel is still the spoken word of God. So he sent his word, this one. And he sent his word, human being in flesh, to deliver the gospel, to tell you. And he says, and he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. That is why God uses vessels. God uses men. Without men, God cannot do anything in the world. That was why he sent Jesus as an example. And that is the lie we are told, that every sickness will be dispelled. Every darkness will be dispelled. Every hatred will be dispelled. envy and animosity will be dispelled by the light of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That is what the word of God is saying here now. So you see that the light has a true channel. The light of knowledge is in learning. If in learning or studying, if you don't learn or study, no knowledge will come. You will not have any knowledge. You will be dark in darkness. The light of wisdom is in revelation. Without revelation, there's no wisdom. There's no revelation, because it is the wisdom of God that reveals the word of God to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And the light of faith is in the word of God. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. That is why when the devil tells you that sickness, whatever sickness it is, will kill you, you know that it will not kill you, because you know you are hearing the word of God, and the word of God builds your faith, and that faith dispels that darkness. I used myself to give an example last week on this program. All the challenges, some of the challenges I went through, it was tough. Sometimes I almost give up hope. But in all that darkness, God was in it. And we can see it is scriptural that in every darkness, God is in every darkness. And we'll go. Let's go to Exodus 20:21. Exodus 20:21. When God appeared to Moses on Mount Sinai, some scriptures will say Horeb. Exodus 20:21. He says, and the people stood afar off, and Moses drew near unto the thick darkness where God was. So in that cancer, God is there. You are not alone in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In that diabetes, God is there. In whatever you're going through, God is there. No matter the challenge, the financial challenges, God is there in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The vision he has given you, he is there waiting for you to step out, and he will step in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That is the God I'm speaking about. In whatever challenge you're going through, that is why you must take a bold step. Listen, I tell people, fear is an advantage. It's meant to be an advantage. Fear is like success and failure. Fear and faith is like success and failure. Fear is not the opposite of faith. And faith is not the opposite of fear. I know that is the doctrine you've heard over and over and over again, but I will disprove it with scriptures, scriptural backing. So you know that faith needs fear to function. Without fear, there is no faith. Without fear, faith cannot work. What is the purpose of faith if fear is not there? What is the purpose of faith if fear is the opposite? It's not possible. It's just like success needs failure to succeed. Success needs failure to succeed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Darkness needs light to be light. For light to be light, it needs darkness. If there's no darkness, what is the glory in light? You won't even know that it's light. If there's no darkness, imagine that God was in the darkness. In the thick darkness, Moses found himself. He would have been scared, but the Bible says where God was. Exodus 20:21. It says where God was in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now let's move on to the glory of God. The Lord will be glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. Now I was talking about fear. Let's go to 2 Timothy 1:6-7. It's going to help us a lot. 2 Timothy 1:6-7. The Bible says, wherefore I put thee in remembrance. He was talking to Paul, talking to Timothy. He says, that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee. You stir up the gift of God, which is in thee. Now listen, what was suppressing the gift of God in Timothy? It was fear. He allowed fear to suppress. Listen, you need fear, but you don't allow fear to suppress your mandate or whatever God has told you to do. He says, stir up the gift of God. It is you that will work that gift in the name of Jesus Christ by the grace and mercy of God. You will work that gift to the glory of God. You will work that gift to the excellence of majesty in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And God will be defended. God will be glorified. I'm telling you, when you step out and do what God is asking you to do, or take the challenge God is telling you to take, you will will meet him there, and I'm telling you, you will not lack. He will provide. He will back you up in the name of Jesus Christ. You will know that this is from God in the name of Jesus Christ. That is why I speak life to you in the name of Jesus Christ. As you are watching me now, life in the name of Jesus Christ. As you are watching me now, health in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak shalom. Shalom peace in the name of Jesus Christ to your bodies in the name of Jesus Christ. Shalom in the name of Jesus. Let God defend you in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Say, I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee. So it is in thee in the name of Jesus. It is there. The gift is there in the name of Jesus Christ. That sickness is only trying to suppress that gift. Look at Timothy. He was anointed too, but being suppressed, he couldn't function. He said, I put thee that you stir up the gift. It is already in you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, which is in thee by the putting on of hands. Impartation. The putting on of hands. Glory to God. Then in verse 7, which is the main one we're going to now, it says, for God had not given us the spirit of fear, listen, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. He didn't give us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Listen, if he said that God did not give us the spirit of fear, if he said God did not give us the spirit of fear, it tells me that the spirit of fear exists. It is there. It is there. But it cannot be a hindrance to you. It is there for the glory of God. Look at when Lazarus, when he was told that Lazarus, Jesus was told that Lazarus was sick and was dying. He said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God. I think John 11, 4. He says, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the King of glory will be glorified thereby. It is not there to kill you in the name of Jesus Christ. It cannot kill you in the name of Jesus Christ. As long as you know this word, it can't kill you in Jesus' name. I'm telling you, this is the light you need in the name of Jesus Christ. I say it again, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You are rising up above that sickness after this night in the name of Jesus Christ. As I'm ministering now, the sickness is being dispelled by the glory and power of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He said, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, which means the spirit of fear does exist. It exists. No, let nobody tell you that it doesn't exist. I've had people say that they don't have fear. I'm telling you, fear is wisdom. If you don't have fear, you are a dangerous person and must be avoided. If you don't have fear, anybody that doesn't have fear is dangerous and must be avoided, because fear, it keeps you, fear controls, it helps you in the name of Jesus Christ. It keeps you away from certain trouble that can be avoided. But when it pertains to your destiny, you don't allow fear to suppress you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody you can read about in the Bible, you will read about them, how they battled with fear. Bible said that the Lord Jesus, he was about to be stoned, and he hid himself from the people. He hid himself from the people and then ran away. And that's the Lord Jesus. Even about the time, I'll take you to those scriptures. About the time he was about to go on the cross, he said, Father, if thou will, let this cup be taken from me. Which tells anybody that he knew he came to fulfill this purpose, but he did not want to die. Because he had flesh like you and I. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And may God be glorified in Jesus' name. Now, if you go to Hebrews 11, 7. Let's go there. May the Lord be glorified. Hebrews 11, 7. Hebrews 11, 7. It says, by faith. Listen to what it says now. By faith, Noah, being warned of God. God had warned him, listen, of things not seen as yet. Things not seen as yet. Faith, in verse 1 it says, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Now listen, in verse 7 it says, by faith Noah, being warned of God, of things not seen as yet, he moved with fear. He moved with fear. So you don't tell me that if you're exercising faith, there's no fear. No. You move with fear. And by the grace of God, I'm writing a book on that. And it will be coming out soon by the grace of God. He said, Noah moved with fear. He moved with fear. It is in fear. God tells you to go and start a ministry or a business or whatever. You move with fear. You don't say fear is not there. Because before you invest any money, you are calculating, oh, will I get it back? Yeah, too many things. What if I get into trouble trying to fulfill this mandate? Too many things to think about. Even when God said, last year, God spoke to us, go on the TV. It was fear that's even Apostle Paul said, fear. I would have come to you since, but fear hindered me. Satan hindered me. How did Satan hinder him? It was spirit of fear. It was the spirit of fear. I have not given you the spirit of fear, which means it exists. You cannot neglect it. It is there. Whether you like it or not, it is there. But it is for your advantage. It is for your empowerment. Because you step out in that fear, then God looks at you and says, this is a man after my own heart. This is a woman after my own heart. Because you step out in fear. Noah moved with fear. You don't achieve any mighty thing in life without moving with fear. It's a lie. Anybody that tells you that, I'm telling you, anybody that says they don't have fear is a dangerous person. Must be avoided in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I'm telling you with scriptural backing, Noah moved with fear. Noah moved with fear, prepared an act to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness, which is by faith. Which is by faith, but he started with fear. He moved with fear and became heir of the righteousness, which is by faith alone. Imagine, but fear was present. Let's go. And may God be truly glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, let's talk about Abraham. Genesis 15, verse 12. I'm going to show you a few people in the Bible that struggled with, that had scary issues, confront them. In the mighty name of Jesus. So what you're going through, God is there. That is one, you must be rest assured. This is scriptural. This is not me making up stories. God is in the challenge with you there in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That God will cause that healing to manifest. You will not know how you get healed. I'm telling you. You see, some of you, you might have gone to the hospital and they tell you they don't know what is wrong with you. They can't see anything because nothing is wrong with you. It is a spiritual battle that you must fight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is a spiritual battle that you must fight in the name of Jesus Christ. And you don't fight it sitting down. You are aggressive. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, spiritual wickedness in high places. But they cannot do us nothing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That is why I'm coming to you in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, I say rise up and walk in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let's go, Abraham. Genesis 15. Verse 12. Genesis 15, verse 12. He says, and when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abram. And lo, an horror of great darkness fell upon him. An horror. You are talking about the father of faith. And Bible is saying, an horror of great darkness, which means he was terrified by it. Fell upon him. An horror of great darkness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And this is Abram. Let's go again. Hebrews 11:8. We'll go back to the Hebrews 11. Lovely chapter in the Bible. For those seeking faith, Hebrews 11 is there. Verse 8, it says, by faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed and went out. He should after receive as an inheritance. After. He wasn't seeing the manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you. Faithful, he will do it. It's not your work. Faithful is he that calleth you. Faithful, he will do it. If he has sent you, you go. You don't fear anything. He is there in the name of Jesus. He is there to defend you. He is there to build you up. He is there to lift you when men say it is impossible. Some people might even desert you along the way. When God was calling me to the ministry, a lot of people ignored me. You know, I understand it's normal. You tell people, oh, God is calling you and you're having all these dreams and everything and he's speaking to you and you know it is the voice of God. You're telling people, and they're looking at you. What are you talking about? But at the end of the day, he is faithful. He will defend the work. If it's his work, he will defend it. It is not. It cannot be manipulation. It is God at work. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, by faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should receive for an inheritance, he obeyed. He obeyed. Imagine the faith. And he went out not knowing whither he went. Not knowing. So when you are stepping out to achieve great things, you don't know where you are going. You just have a mindset that I'm going to succeed in what I'm doing. I'm going to prosper in the work I'm doing. I'm going to be backed up by the living God in the name of Jesus Christ. That the God who brought the idea. Wisdom comes from God. Ideas comes from God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the God who backs up the idea, he will defend the work in Jesus' name. And you will not fail in Jesus' name. He will defend you in Jesus' name. No more oppression. As you are preparing to enter the new year, no death will be recorded in your household in the name of Jesus Christ. You will live and not die in the name of Jesus. You will live to declare the works of God in this land of the living in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That God that put me here, he will defend you in Jesus' name. He will back you up in Jesus' name. Anybody that say no, God will force the yes on them in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. They may not accept you, but if God has accepted you, you go ahead. Nothing can stop you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The blood is upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ. And upon your household. In the name of Jesus Christ. It will be full testimonies all through in the name of Jesus Christ. I say from now till the new year, you will be recording testimonies in the name of Jesus Christ. And I'm hearing people's papers, documents from the Home Office will be arriving today, in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are expecting it, I say today, yours. In fact, you receive it, it will come in the name of Jesus Christ. The same God who will defend you in Jesus' name. He will defend you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yeah, I spoke about Jesus already. Now let's go to the Apostle Paul, 1 Corinthians 2, 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 3. May God be glorified, supremely glorified in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 3. Now listen to what the Apostle Paul said here. Listen to what he said. He said, and I was with you in weakness. In weakness, I was with you. In weakness, I came to you. And in fear, and in trembling, in fear, I came to you to minister the gospel. In fear, I came to minister, I'm telling you. In fear. For God will be glorified. In fear. It cannot be the opposite of faith. No. It works. It supports faith to manifest in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. If the mighty Apostle Paul, he came in fear. Don't tell me faith is the opposite of fear. It's not. He came in fear. He said in fear, in weakness. Bible saying in Galatians chapter 4, think about verse 13, about that. He spoke about the Apostle Paul, how he came in sick with infirmity, even in his body. Imagine the apostle. He said, at first when I came unto you. So he came with fear, but he fulfilled his mandate. I have finished my course, he said. He ran the race. He finished his course. The Lord will give us the grace to finish our course in Jesus' name. And as you are watching me, that God will do it for you too in Jesus' name. He will do it for you in Jesus' name. Let's go to Philippians 2:12 because I want us to be quick. Philippians 2:12. Now it says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, he said, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation. You must work out your salvation with fear and trembling. It is your salvation. You have to work it out in the name of Jesus. It is your salvation. Nothing can hinder you. You have to receive Jesus as the Lord and Savior of your life. I'm telling you, things will begin to happen. When you dedicate your life to Jesus, remove your eyes from all these petty things that hinder us from the presence of God. That I'm telling you, listen, recently a friend of mine, about a few months ago, he said he needed a job. And we were praying, you know. I'm not taking the glory at all because I didn't do it. And eventually he got a job, you know, he's in Germany. He got a job and he didn't get a job. He got agency gave him work. And I told him that the work would be permanent. And he eventually became permanent, but it took time. There was challenges up and down, you know, about 3 months, but he got the job permanent. And recently, just yesterday, he called me again after some few months in the row. And he said to me that he's been having challenges at work, you know. And the first thing the Holy Spirit spoke to me was, ask him if he pays his tithe. And I said, do you pay your tithe? And he started, immediately he started, I already knew the answer. He doesn't pay his tithe. He doesn't. And I said, you are hindering yourself. I said, go and study Malachi chapter 3. It is your scripture. Will a man rob God? But you have robbed me. He says, wherein have we robbed thee? He says, in tithes and offering. He said, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake if you pay your tithe and offering. If you don't, he said, you are cursed with a curse. Challenges up and down. He will defend you if you do what he wants you to do, to the glory of God. And he said, where should I pay? I said, go and pay it. You have a church you're attending in Germany? He said, yes. And incidentally, during the conversation, I started talking about that people get jobs and I was just led to start saying about that. People get jobs and they stop going to church. And he said, oh, incidentally, I got a part-time job again I'm doing at the weekend. And so I haven't been in church for a while. I said, that's the problem. That's the problem. Now the job is more important than the God that brought the job. May the Lord lead us in his wisdom in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say and I pray, as you go to sleep, that God will defend you in his grace and mercy. No more torment in the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say this day, this very day, testimonies will flood your doors in Jesus' name. Letters of breakthroughs will come in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord that has spoken will bring it to pass in Jesus' name. As many as believe it, it will flood your homes. Today there is a release in the name of Jesus Christ. A release, and I came to deliver that release. I deliver it in the name of Jesus Christ, and I believe you have received it in Jesus' name. And let the blood back you up in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May God build you up in Jesus' name. May God equip you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May God lift you in the name of Jesus Christ. May God enhance you in Jesus' name. And just to show some of my books, you know, some of them are very controversial topics, but I'm telling you, go and read it, and the Lord will reveal what was written in it in Jesus' name. He will build you up in Jesus' name. This is one of them. They are on Amazon. If you type my name on Amazon, Chimezie Okonkwo, you see my books. The Lord will back you up in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And if you are led to support us, may God bless you as you do it. Jesus, if you are led, in the mighty name of Jesus, he will defend you in Jesus' name. He will show you his grace. If you need prayers or counseling, call us on that number, and that the Lord, the God that brought us here, he will meet your need in Jesus' name. Be blessed. Until next week, same time, same place, in Jesus' name. And I say shalom in Jesus' name. Amen.